today marks my last day in this office after working here 5 years. I can't believe this is my last day here. I've been working in this office for the last 5 years, and for the last 2 years of the pandemic, I've been seeing all of my clients virtually, but I've been doing it sitting in that chair. But I am saying farewell to this office. I'll share more details later in this video why I'm saying farewell to this office, but for now, I need to pack my stuff. My dear friend and office mate hand lettered this. Look at that. Gonna need a special spot wherever I go next. This is gonna be obsolete now. I have my last two clients to meet with. We're meeting virtually over the computer, but it's still gonna be really sad. That's it. I'm a little sad. I had thought about whether I really wanted to film this for a video or not because I wanted to kind of savor the moment that this is my last day seeing clients in this office. I can't believe it. Rather than focusing on making a video, but I realized I'm totally gonna wanna go back and rewatch this video and just remember what it was like to work here, remember what this office has been for me. So partly I'm documenting this totally selfishly for myself. Well, today is my last day seeing clients in the office, but I do have an office mate and she is coming in for one more day tomorrow as well before she moves to her new office. And then we're gonna come in a few days and move all of our stuff out. But it is really bizarre that I'm never gonna see a client in this office, virtually or in person, ever again. I'm gonna miss you, little office. You can see my office mate and I have cleared out this shelf. We still have the background of our therapy sessions intact. I cleared most of my decor from this table, and this drawer is empty. And today I finished clearing out my filing cabinet. I won't lie, that file cabinet was such a hot mess. Let's just say that I had a lot of files that were more than 7 years old, and I did get to purge a lot of my old client files. Well, I realize I haven't explained why I'm moving at all yet, but it's the end of the day. I gotta go pick up my kids from childcare, so I guess I'll be telling you about that later. Bye-bye, little office. This is my last time ever driving to this office. Here goes nothing. My office mate already tidied up some more. Oh my goodness. So this is the current state of affairs in here. I've shared this office for the last 5 years with a very dear friend and fellow therapist, and she has found a new office, and this is a blessing for me, but she is taking the majority of the furniture with her to the new office. So any minute now, she should be arriving in the parking lot with a U-Haul, and we're gonna move out all the furniture together so that she can take it with her, and I can say farewell to my physical office location. Okay, more details to come later, but I figured I'd start the tidying process, which she already started. I'll continue the tidying process.
We're gonna move this anyway.
Is there a trick to this?
Oh, no.
I'm gonna mess up the door. Let it be known that my landlord approved this double stick tape.
Come on, buddy. You got this.
I feel like this is symbolic. I don't want to let go of this office, and neither does this nameplate.
Oh, come on, buddy.
Oh, I got this when I very first got my own office, and it's coming with me. Who else is going to use it anyway, right? I think my memory card ran out of space when I got this thing off, but it went all the way down to like the plaster. Do you see that? You can't win them all. It's empty.
Hey, I think
it's my closing shot. So it's a few days later, and as these things go, I just got caught up in all the stuff that was going on move out day that I didn't have a chance to pause and explain the full story of why I'm moving. So I think you've gathered by now that I'm moving, but I haven't explained at all where I'm moving to and why I'm making that move. So for the last 10 years that my husband and I have been living in the San Francisco Bay Area, we have been looking for an opportunity to move to San Diego. My husband and I have always had a shared value of looking to curate our lives in such a way so that we are really excited about the way our life is structured and how we're leaning into our values right now. We want to create a life today that is something to look forward to waking up to. And the whole story of why I built Private Practice Skills is a critical component of that journey because I really wanted to build a passive source of income where I could be at home almost all week long with my two girls, being mom, while also doing something I really love that earns income. And among other things, leaving the hustle of Bay Area culture and returning to what feels like home in San Diego has been something my husband and I have put in this category of trying to work towards curating the life that we really want to live. And now that our girls are still small and not yet in school, it feels like now is kind of the best time to make that happen. So when some final stars came into alignment related to my husband's career that created the opportunity for us to make this move, we jumped on it. We are moving to San Diego in just 3 weeks. Ah! Wish me luck. Now, logistically, as far as how we're doing this move, I obviously moved out of my therapy office, which I've always had a physical therapy office as long as I've been in private practice. Even though I've been seeing my clients virtually for the last 2 years, when we first moved to San Diego, the plan is to live in a temporary rental, and I will be seeing my clients virtually still from that temporary rental. And while we're in that rental, we'll sell our house up here. Once we sell our house up here, we'll look for a house to buy down there, and then we'll move into that house. And at some point after that, I will make a decision about whether it makes sense to rent a therapy office, potentially see clients in person, or if I want to stay virtually working from home. So I'm definitely going to take you along for the journey because I honestly have no idea what it's going to look like, but I have always had a physical office to see my clients. And now I'm going to be doing what I know so many of you are doing, and I'm going to be seeing my clients virtually from where I live. Now, as far as preparations that I've made for my practice before moving down to San Diego, aside from obviously moving out of my office, is I've gotten a mailbox in San Diego, because as of right now, we don't even know what neighborhood we're gonna be living in San Diego. And I also don't even know if I'm going to have a physical office location there ever. I am TBD on that. So what I did was I set up a mailbox for my business. That way I have a business address located in the city that I'm moving to, even when I don't know where I'm moving to in that city. And I can do all of the city business licensure stuff and have a proper address for all of the things we need an address for. I think in the future, I'll probably make a whole video about setting up a mailbox when you are doing virtual therapy from home. We'll save that for another video though. Well, that's really all for today. I just wanted to document this journey, as I said, largely selfishly for myself so I can go back and revisit these kind of nostalgic memories. This office has been such a wonderful privilege to work in, and I also know I have so much to look forward to for whatever the future holds. And before we close, I'd like to thank TherapyNotes.com for sponsoring this video. One of the many advantages to having an EHR platform to manage your practice is you can just be pretty much anywhere and be nomadic and access all of your client paperwork wherever you are. You saw in this video that I packed up all of my old files into one of those portable filing cabinets, and that was from before the EHR days of my life. So I have to keep some of those files on file for 7 years, but everything else, you can just travel virtually. Therapy Notes offers an entire suite of services that makes managing your practice smooth and easy. So if you're interested in checking it out, you can get 2 months to try it for free with no commitment just by clicking the link in the description of this video. Well, I hope you enjoy joining me as I make this transition out of having a physical office location for my practice
For those of you who've been seeing clients virtually from home for some time now, let me know what your hot tips are in the comments below so, you know, I can be prepared and also to help out other folks watching this video. And until next time, from one therapist to another, I wish you well.